Midnight Sky is a post-apocalyptic tale that follows Augustine, played by George Clooney, a lonely scientist in the Arctic, as he races to stop Sully, played by Felicity Jones, and her fellow astronauts from returning home to a mysterious global catastrophe. George Clooney directed this one with a screenplay by Mark L. Smith, who also co-wrote The Revenant and Overlord. And while I have enjoyed films Clooney's directed before, and I did include this on my most anticipated movies of the month feature, I still approach this one with a bit of caution. His efforts behind the camera are considerably hit and miss, and even when I saw the trailer for this, I wasn't totally sure what to expect. But what we got was fine. Not a bad film, though not also one of his best. The film essentially cuts back and forth between two different stories. Clooney, alone on the Arctic, trying to make contact with the spacecraft, and then the crew inside the spacecraft itself. Clooney has issues getting a hold of them, and thus their interactions throughout the entire movie are at a bare minimum. And especially because the crew in space are unaware as to what's going on, things are fairly mellow with them for a good majority of the film. The stakes weren't particularly high in many of their scenes, at least not until the second half, and for the first half, it was just them talking and reflecting on life, and the scenes with Clooney, who's feeling an extreme sense of loneliness in the Arctic, have that same reflective feel, as he attempts to bond with a young girl named Iris who is hiding in his base. Clooney as a director here is trying to recreate the feel of other somber sci-fi films such as Children of Men, Moon, and Gravity, the latter of which he also starred in. Those films didn't have something action-packed going on every other scene, there were moments that were very minimalistic, and the latter two films I mentioned have a limited cast yet still had very effective stories with a lot of dramatic weight. And similar to all those movies, there's a lot of attention to detail here on the technical side of things. This film is absolutely beautiful to look at. The cinematography is stunning. I loved a lot of the shots of outer space and the Arctic. Regarding Clooney as a director, I will say that while his films haven't all totally worked, he definitely knows what he's doing when it comes to the craft of filmmaking. He has an eye for what makes a film look great, and it's especially effective when he has the right script. Though as far as this script goes, the punch that films like Moon and Gravity had just wasn't felt as much here. Now, it's a well-acted film. I thought Clooney's performance was great, as was Felicity Jones, and you had a solid cast who made up the rest of Jones' crew that includes David Oyelowo, Tiffany Boone, Damian Bashir, and Kyle Chandler, and they were all fine with what they were given. But there just wasn't that many dramatic beats to make for a completely engaging experience. It's Clooney trying to contact this crew, and then the scenes of the crew themselves having these pseudo-philosophical conversations that had little to no impact on the story. You probably could have told this story in about an hour or 20 minutes or so, rather than 2 hours. I wouldn't call this flat out boring, but it does lead to some pacing issues, especially early on. The performances are what makes these characters likable and make me care enough as far as what happens to them. And during all this downtime, there are plenty of gorgeous images to look at, but it's a grim film that recreates the feel of better movies that had plenty more to say, while itself having nothing special to say. In terms of the story, it picks up more in the second half, though it's still not enough to give it a wholehearted recommendation. I'd say the good just outweighs the bad enough for it to be a casual watch, but nothing you need to absolutely see. The Midnight Sky gets a 6 out of 10. So let me know, did you see The Midnight Sky or are you planning to see it and what were your thoughts? Did you like the story and what's one of your favorite sci-fi movies? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoy this video, please like it and share it, and for more movie reviews and film discussion, please make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay updated. Thanks for watching everyone, and I'll catch you next time.